Welcome back. We are now supposed to look at another simplification example where we have A simplify x. We have x plus 1 by 2x minus 1. Okay, we have to simplify. In short, we have to multiply this and this because you can see each one is enclosed in brackets. We have this one and this one. Then when there is no sign here, it means you have multiplication. When there is nothing written there, it means you have multiplication. So the way we handle such a question, we multiply this, like we multiply x by each one of the terms in the next factor. Each one of the terms. So we shall multiply x by 2x and x by negative 1. And we shall repeat the same on the other one. We shall repeat the same on the other one. We shall multiply 1 by 2x and the same 1 by negative x. So this one also, we shall multiply it by this one and this one. So the first one, we multiply it by each one of the terms in the next factor. Second one, we multiply by each one of the terms in the second factor. So let's see how we are going to proceed. So we shall say x multiplied by 2x, we shall have 2x index 2. And again, we shall say x multiplied by negative 1, we shall have negative x. Okay, so as you have seen, we have multiplied this term by each one of the terms in the next expression. So let's continue. We also multiply the second term by each one of those. So we shall say 1 multiplied by 2x, we shall have positive 2x. And we shall say 1 multiplied by negative 1, we shall have negative 1. Okay. So once we finish multiplying, it's now a matter of collecting like terms. So as you have seen, we have 2x squared. This is just alone. And we are lucky the terms are collected for us in advance. So it's a matter of now adding and subtracting. So we have negative x plus 2x. Here we shall have plus x. And this one is just alone. So you can see they are not like terms. So we shall end here. There is nothing that we can do. We can't proceed any further than this. So basically, this is how we expand. Looking at B, we have x minus 1 index 2. Okay, so we have x minus 1 index 2. The way we expand such an expression, of course, when you have index 2, it means the same thing has been repeated. So when we have x minus 1 index 2, it means we have 2 x minus 1s. So we have x minus 1 and another x minus 1. So as usual, you multiply this term by that term and by also, you do the same to the second one, right, by this one, and also by the other one. Okay, so that's what you do. So we shall say, x by x, we shall have x square, and we shall say, x by negative 1, we shall have negative x. Okay, so x has been multiplied by each one of the terms in the next factor, next expression. So coming to the second one, we say negative 1 by x, we shall have negative x, and we have negative 1 by negative 1, we have positive 1. You can see the terms, the right terms are collected for us in advance. So we just say x square, then minus x will give us minus 2x. So, basically, we can't proceed any further than that, so we need to just end there. So this is how we simplify, this is how we expand factors when we are given them in brackets like the way we had those two questions. Okay, let's look at the last example. Look at the last example, C. So under C, we have two factors, of course. We have 4x minus 5 and another 3x plus 2. Okay, so we have to multiply these two. So as usual, the way we are doing it, you multiply this by each one of the terms here, each one of the terms. Similarly, you multiply this one by each one of the terms in the next term. So multiply this term by each one of the terms in the next expression. So you say 4x by each one of these. And you come here negative 5 by each one of these. And you'll be done. So we say 4x by 3x. 4x by 3x. So it's like we are multiplying two quantities, two sets of quantities at one go. So we have 4 times 3, this will give us 12, and x times x will give us x squared. So 4x by 3x will give us 12x squared. So now coming to the other one, we say 4x multiplied by 2, we have 8x. Okay, so we have multiplied this one by each one of these two. So getting now to the other one, we shall say negative 5 multiplied by 3x. So we have negative 15x. And the same one, negative 5 by positive 2, we have negative 10. So once we do that one, it's a matter of now adding or subtracting the like terms. So you can see we have 8x minus 15x, we get negative 7x minus 10. So once we reach here, then we are done. We cannot proceed any further than this. So basically, this is how we proceed whenever we are told to expand, whenever we are told to simplify such questions, whenever we are told to simplify that question. Okay. Now, before closing, let me show you the shortest cut of expanding repeated terms. Expanding repeated terms. So like this one here, when you have a term, when you have an expression which has been repeated, you see, you have 2x squared minus 3 or to the index 2. So this basically means, x squared minus 3 multiplied by another 2x squared minus 3. So basically, this means these are repeated there too, like this. Okay. Now, I just want to show you the way you expand this one quickly. So the way you expand this one quickly, you just need to square this one. The first term, you square it. You square it. So you square this one, 2 square, you get 4. X index 2 square, you get x index 4. So you square this one. When you square this one, you get 4x index 4. You square this one, 2, you get 4. You square this one, is a square already. You square it again, you get 4. Okay. And once you square this one, you get the first term. To get the next term, you say, the whole of this one, 2x squared minus 2x squared multiplied by, so you say 2x squared multiplied by 3. 2x squared multiplied by negative 3. You get negative 6x squared. You get negative 6x squared. So 2x squared times negative 3, you get negative 6x squared. Now this one you multiply it by 2. So that you get negative 2x. And this last term, negative 3, This one is just a square two, so you say negative 3 times another negative 3, so that you get a positive 9. So basically, this is how you handle such expansions. You square this one, you get the first term, then you multiply this one and this one, you multiply this one and this one. Whatever you get, you multiply by 2, so that you get the term in the middle. And the term here, you just square this one and get it. So basically, this is one way of expanding, one way of expanding repeated terms. Thank you very much for your attention.